Hello everyone. In this video, I will do a close visual walkthrough of the parts and functions of my new Hioki 3030-10 analog multimeter. The actual functional test will be in a separate video. If you wish to view the functional testing straight away, you may want to skip this. I will provide a link to the description as soon as I upload it. But for those who are interested in the physical aspect of the Hioki 3030-10 analog multimeter, stick around and I'll share what I find out. By the way, I grabbed the chance to order this from Amazon because of a big discount and free shipping, as I've always wanted a Hioki analog multimeter. Here is the retail box. Just like other packaging from Hioki, it looks professional and sturdy, with a good description of the item at the front. Hioki still makes their analog multimeter just like their digital multimeters in their manufacturing plant in Japan. It includes these bundle accessories, the LN220730 test leads, the plastic carrying case, and two AA batteries which were factory installed. This is the optional high voltage probe which I have no plans on getting. The bundled clamshell type plastic carrying case is a good accessory. You need not look for a third party case. The cover cannot be detached, but it provides a neat, well-organized space for the unit and its test leads. Just make sure that you firmly press the plastic caps to securely clip the cover in place. The quality of the plastic isn't something extravagant, but it's thick enough to protect the meter well during storage and transport. Its handle also doubles as a tilt stand. Be aware though that the tilt stand kind of wobbles a little bit, but it does the job. They included two fold-out instruction manuals, one in Japanese and the other in English. The manual is well illustrated, well written and clear. In fact, if you don't have a lot of knowledge of electricity or electronics, I highly suggest that you read this instruction manual first before using the multimeter. In fact, for safety reasons, it's best to be familiar with the user's manual of whatever analog multimeter you have before using it. It's because the analog multimeter isn't as forgiving as its digital equivalent in terms of operator mistake. It is easy to make a mistake that can damage it and possibly injure the operator or the user. This is the pair of the bundle test leads called L920730 rated 10 amperes. It has a well-designed finger guards provided with removable tip covers, which exposes the gold-plated metallic pins. The test leads have a category rating that can safely handle the 600 volts Cat3 rating of the instrument. In a nutshell, a category rating is a standard means to identify that a certain electrical tool is suitable for a defined electrical environment. Here is a drawing from the instruction manual that helps illustrate it. Category 4 is that electrical location defined from the source distribution transformer through the service drop up to the revenue meter. The 3030-10 is not rated for this, so it should not be used in this category location. Meanwhile, Category 3 describes the electrical environment from the main distribution panel board including the distribution feeders and distribution circuits, including the large load directly connected to the panel board, for example, this electric motor. Category 2 describes that electrical point where the end-use equipment is connected, like this outlet here and a device connected to it. The Hioki 3030-10 is rated for Category 3 600 volts, so it can be used in this Category 3 environment from the distribution panel board down to the outlets. You may have noticed that the range switch, also known as the function selector, has a white strip. Originally, it wasn't there. I wanted to improve its visibility, so I attached a white strip of sticker. The Hioki 3030-10 isn't much wider than the palm of my hand. It's rather lightweight and a little smaller than the Sanwa YX361TR, for example. But it is just as thick, or even a little thicker, than the Sanwa YX361TR. It would seem to me that this was really made to be simple but robust. There are only two input terminals, the positive input terminal and the negative input terminal. The function selector is surrounded by 20 distinct functions, excluding the off position. There is no color coding. Everything is printed in plain white. Even the positive input terminal is just plain black. In other multimeters, this positive input terminal is color-coded red. On the other hand, the printing is clear, bold, and there is enough space provided between the functions. The selector makes an assured click every time it moves into position. They placed the off position right smack in the center. This is good because it provides symmetry between the AC voltage functions and the DC voltage functions. The AC voltage ranges at the right side go from 12 volt to 600 volt. At the left side, the DC voltage functions ranges from 0.3 volts to 600 volts DC. At the bottom, we find the 1.5 volt battery tester, which loads the battery with a 10 ohm resistor. A DC ammeter function allows for current measurement between 60 microamperes to 300 milliamperes DC. Over on this side, we find the ohmmeter function, or the resistor test function. It has manual ranges from X1 to X1000, with LED lighting test position at the ×10 range. Notice that there is no continuity buzzer or continuity LED that you may find in other analog multimeters. Nevertheless, the ×1 or the X1 range is good enough for continuity test. This is the zero-ohm adjuster knob, which is slightly recessed. We use this to reset the resistance of the test leads to zero before we test a resistor. This black head of a plastic screw is used to adjust the needle position to exactly zero in case it's not at the zero position. The upper half of the meter is dedicated to the analog display panel. It is covered with a crystal clear lens, and the scale plate is as bright as they come. You may notice that the scale bars have no mirror, which you may find in other analog multimeters, like the Sanwa YX361TR. Here is the mirror arc, just under the ohmmeter scale of the YX361TR. The mirror helps to avoid reading errors due to parallax phenomenon when viewing the scale at an angle. Some of you may be disappointed that the mirror is missing at the Hioki 3030-10. But personally, it's not a big deal for me since I prefer to read the scale perpendicular to my eyes anyway. Besides, the printing of the scale graduations, including the characters, is big and bold as well and makes for easy reading. The analog plate has six scales. From top to bottom, the red ohmmeter scale with a full scale value of 3 kiloohms. The three black scales for AC and DC voltages with full scale values of 30, 12, and 6 respectively. The red temperature scale, and at the bottom, the black scale for the 1.5 volt battery tester. The temperature scale is just there as a legacy function, but it cannot be used, since Hioki no longer manufactures the temperature probe for it. So we can just ignore the temperature function. Only 5 scales are of practical use. Now, one may wonder, how do we read an analog display, given that it only has 5 usable scales, whereas there are 20 distinct range positions around the function selector? The solution is a clever application of simple math. Notice that for voltage functions, the manual ranges are all in multiples of 3, 12, or 6. In the AC voltage function, we have 12, 30, 120, 300, and 600. Likewise, in the DC voltage functions, it has 0.3 volt, 3, 12, 30, 120, 300, and 600. Looking back at the analog panel, we see that the full scale values of the AC and DC voltages are exact multiples of the voltage ranges below. So we have 6, 12, and 30. To get the correct reading then, regardless of the range position, simply apply the appropriate factor of either 0.1, 10, or 100. Notice also the range of the DC current function, 60 microamperes, 30 milliamperes, and 300 milliamperes, all multiples of 3 as well. With regard to the ohmmeter value, the red scale on top, simply multiply the readings at the ohmmeter scale by the factor of the selected range. So whatever value the needle shows, multiply it by either 1, 10, 100, or 1000. A precautionary notice is also placed at the back to remind the user of safety. The serial number at the back of the instrument actually contains the code for the date it was manufactured. The first 2 digits represent the year, the next 2 digits the month. This particular unit, therefore, was made in Japan last May 2022, just barely 4 months ago. Two Toshiba AA disposable batteries were factory installed. I understand this was probably because they tested it at the factory. I would have preferred that the batteries were removed afterwards. This is to avoid damage to the instrument due to a possible battery leak. It's a good thing that this is a fresh unit, so the probability of battery leak is not likely. I find the electronic components well organized and neat. Even the batteries have their own circuit board. We see the mentioned fuse protection. It is a ceramic fuse rated at 250 volts, 500 milliamperes. Hioki included a spare. This is good. One of the advantages of an analog multimeter over a digital multimeter is that an analog multimeter can measure AC and DC voltage and DC current without batteries, whereas a digital multimeter will not turn on at all without batteries. For an analog multimeter like the Hioki DT3030-10, the voltage test points will be the ones that will provide power to the meter to turn its needle. The batteries are just there for the ohmmeter functions, since it needs to provide voltage, it needs to provide battery voltage to resistors being tested in order to determine their ohmic values. As you may already know, an analog multimeter is designed to measure AC voltage by what is referred to as an average sensing method. For as long as the AC voltage is a sine wave, in either 50 or 60 Hz, the Hioki 3030-10 will measure it accurately as an RMS value. Even a slight distortion of, say, 5% harmonics distortion will not significantly affect its accuracy, which makes this suitable for a residential and certain small commercial installation within the Cat 3 600-volt rating. Is the Hioki 3030-10 worth buying then, considering that there are lower-cost alternative analog multimeters, which were also Japanese-made, like the Sanwa YX361TR? I can only speak for myself and say that I like them both. Although I have no immediate need for an analog multimeter, it doesn't mean that it has no practical purpose. I can just leave the battery out of it, and it will measure AC and DC voltage at any time without me worrying about battery leak. I appreciate that the Hioki 3030-10 is Cat 3 600 volts rated. It comes with a good carrying case, clearly laid out controls, easy to read analog panel, well insulated and thick test leads, and very recent manufacturing date of May 2022. It doesn't have as many measurement functions as the Sanwa YX361TR, for example. But perhaps for some of us, what the Hioki 3030-10 offers is all that we need. It has an elegant appeal to its simplicity. That said, between an analog multimeter and a digital multimeter, I believe that beginning electrical practitioners would be better served with a good, true RMS digital clamp meter to start with. It's just my personal opinion. Please watch out for the link below to the functional testing of the Hioki 3030-10. Stay safe. Thank you for watching.